So, then we were talking about Final Fantasy 15, and this is Realism and Purpose in Final Fantasy 15, presented by me. And so, the goal of this game is kind of interesting. So, Tetsuya Nomura was originally the director for this game, but he moved to take care of Kingdom Hearts 3, which is coming out soon, in 2014, and he put Tabata in charge. And so Tabata had just done So there was an interview with him in 2015 with IGN, where he said, "It's very true. We're similarly trying to create a more realistic feel to the world and a more realistic Final Fantasy," he admits. "The kind of Final Fantasy I want to make, it's one where you feel this is a real, living, breathing world, and these things could exist in real life. The character is the same too. It's a real person with real motivations. Your friends and comrades are the same, even the monsters. They're credible. They could exist and would live in this environment and behave this way. Just to get that feeling of credibility is something that I really want to do," which is something that he aimed to do in Type Zero too. If you guys remember, it was a pretty dark one. So, it's the same idea. So how does he do that? The question is, here, is how does the music do that? How does the music add to the realism that he wanted to make happen? So first thing in chapter one is in this game is Departure. And where we meet our characters, we have a setting of a car broken down on the side of the road. You guys can see that there if you haven't played the game. This is all new and wonderful to you. So in this setting, the things I find interesting already, we can see modern cars, and then a little while later, a buggy passes by. We can see clothes that look modern. We can see billboards that look real. We can see power lines. This is on a road. Right? These are all things that exist in our reality, okay? And so, the music that's played during this is called Broken Down. And before we jump into it, it's a blues harmonica song, and it's just blues harmonica. That's it. And for those of you who are hip to like music theory lingo, there's flatted thirds and flatted sevenths. There's a little bit of a shuffle that happens about midway through, and there are bent notes. So let's listen to that. America. We're in a location that looks kind of like, you know, Arizona or something like that, and we're hearing blues music, right? Okay, so next bit, we move on to their car's broken down, so they have to push it. Okay,
push.
Okay. So they're pushing the car. What I like about this is it's actually like it's a realistic solution to the problem. It's not like they have magic or something like that, right? It's not like there's some like crazy device that we can just do this and push, you know. No, there's actually have to push the car to the nearest town. And so the music that we hear is Stand By Me. And I don't know if you guys have probably heard this before. You probably are aware of the song, but there's a version that was made specifically for the game by Florence and the Machine. So we'll listen to a little bit of this. Oh, it's so chill.
Lo-fi hip hop's like a tool of being studied
24/7.
when the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see.
So it's wonderful, and I wish we could keep listening to it. But the thing that I think is interesting about it is that the whole thing is about friendship or brotherhood, which is really like the main theme of this game. And that's just something I thought was interesting to point out. But we're talking about America. This is a 1960s American pop song. But here's the interesting thing about it. They chose a modern singer. They chose a modern artist to have it played. They didn't have Benny King. They didn't have the original artist play. Then it would sound kind of like a Fallout game or something like that, right? It's a thing.
Surprise, it's actually Fallout.
So that's, to me, that's the point of why they chose a modern singer doing a modern rendition of that song. Okay, so anyway, they push the car, they get all the way over to the town that's called Hammerhead. Well, it's not really a town, it's more like a truck stop, right? And which you guys can kind of see up here. And it's complete with everything a truck stop would have. There's a diner, there's a garage, there's a gas station, a convenience store, there's even a trailer for you to spend the night in. Now, and if you look around, people are in normal clothing. It's just a normal bookstore, like a real place. Even the dialogue uses things like American slang and stuff like that. And every, I mean, obviously it's a part of a normalization. No, what is it called? The vocalization thing. Part of it's going to be a vocalization thing, but I find it interesting that they're using the slang they're using and using the accents that they are. Kind of a southern accent with everybody. So the music, which we'll play for a moment, I like to think of it as just, it's like Americana, it's like light southern rock. Let's listen to this for a moment. Second. What I think is interesting about it is the instrumentation that they chose to use, right? We have organ, we have acoustic guitar, we have some mandolin doing some tremolo picking, we have the harmonica, we're back with the harmonica, we have a tambourine in there, we have a shaker, and a little bit later, I think at about 2 minutes, it really turns into like, it feels like a bar band to me. We have electric guitar, we have drums, we have bass guitar in there. Cool, so you guys get the idea. But so far, we haven't really heard anything that like sounds like a Final Fantasy game, right? We're used to, everything that we heard before was like, had strings, a lot of cinematic, kind of lush things going on, but not really, we haven't really heard that. We've heard great tunes, but nothing really emblematic of the Final Fantasy series. So that brings us to this little bit. We go over to Cindy, who's one of the characters in the game, and we get a quest from her. And it's, we have to kill these giant scorpions in the wilderness, okay? Go out into Arizona and kill giant scorpions.
I think that's actually true in Arizona. That's just my opinion.
I've never been. Anyway, okay. So anywho. The song, the music that plays is unapologetically Final Fantasy. So let's just listen to that for a minute. Actually, we'll listen to it for a minute. Then we'll talk about the other stuff. Okay. Okay, so there's so much freaking going on, even in that first 19 seconds. Okay, so number one, there's this syncopated ostinato. Does anybody know what an ostinato is? What does it mean, sir? It's a very good.
I couldn't tell you, but I know what it is.
Okay.
That's fair.
Yes.
It's a repetitive rhythmic pattern that happens over.
You got it. You got it. It's a repetitive rhythmic pattern or a repetitive. All right.
Two extra bonus points.
or repetitive, like bass figure or something like that. But yes, exactly. So it looks like this. We have this thing here. We've heard this in every Final Fantasy, and I know some of you don't know how to read sheet music, but that's okay. The way I like to look at this is just 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 1 2 1 2. So 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2. Right? You've all heard that a billion times, right? In Final Fantasy X, it's in everyone. In some capacity, it's in everyone. Next, we also have the crystal theme, like the ascending and descending arpeggios that happens in all the Final Fantasies, that they have it in the strings. And lastly, emblematic of battle music from Final Fantasy, dissonance and chromaticism. I'm just going to briefly play those first few seconds again, just so we can hear that. So, battle rhythm. Cool. All right, moving on. So then we have the radio. So a large part of this game is you and the boys just driving around Eos, just cruising around Eos. That's what you do. And you go to all these places that way. And one of the things later in the game, you're actually able to get like soundtracks from the earlier games, so you can listen to all those early soundtracks. But before that, you just get these kind of like generic tunes that you get to listen to. So this tune is called Easy Drum and Bass. And before we jump into it, what I want you to listen for is, number one, it's synth heavy. It kind of reminds me of a 13 kind of thing, because it's synth heavy. There's some trap hi-hat. Anybody listen to trap? Okay, so whenever you hear that, like, but if you're listening to hip-hop and you're, that's like a trap hi-hat, right? It's like one of the things that happens. And then there's some kind of, like, dubstep-y. So I'll jump ahead a little bit, but just to give you guys an idea of what kind of music this is.
It's almost like FMR again last year.
I'm going to correct myself right now. That one wasn't a triplet, but there are triplets elsewhere. That was 8 notes. Anyway, so continuing on. So, presumably, I mean, they're listening to it in the car. Why else would they be listening to it? That's the question we have to... Why are we hearing this music?
It came from the car.
Because... if they kept it on, though. Okay? Alright? So, presumably, it's what the boys like, right? And what I think it does is it connects us, real people, with the boys. Because, presumably, considering it's modern, presumably, it's what we like, right? And there's a lot of tunes that are on the radio that are kind of similar to that, or they're, like, a little bit heavier, or more, like, metal-ish and stuff. So it's kind of interesting. You know, it's all Ignis, you know, it's not. He's the one who likes the trap. Okay. Okay. So, goals of game music. I see it as there are two goals. Number one is to represent the setting, whether that be the action that's occurring, or the location that it is, or a combination of the two. Number one is to represent the setting. Number two, how should we feel about the setting, or how should we feel about what's going on? Because we could have somebody like be killed or something, but it could be like happy. You know what I mean? Like it's think of like you vanquishing a boss or something like that.
Think of Crab Rave.
Okay. I'm going to defer to you on that.
Sorry.
Youngin?
Anyway, my feelings are not spicy enough.
Okay. Okay, so anyway. I look at this as the familiar. With this music, I look at it as the familiar versus beyond our world. So we have music like we heard for Hammerhead and and various other cities throughout the game that are the music of towns. It's the music of people, human beings. It's the music of people. It's our music. There's familiarity there. Oftentimes, it's mostly diatonic and consonant. For those of you who aren't music theory people, diatonic is when music stays in the same key. It doesn't move around. Well, it can't, but you guys know what I mean. It doesn't. There's not a lot of. We'll just leave it at that. So we don't have time. We just don't have time. And oftentimes, it's small ensemble music, just like we heard before. We didn't hear a whole, for Hammerhead, we didn't hear a whole, like, choir. We didn't hear, a big string section or anything like that. Small ensemble music. Now, and I look at that as being comfort. That's music that's comforting for us, because we're familiar with it. Then the other side of it is that we have the beyond, the dungeons, where demons lurk, right? That's more chromatic and dissonant, as oftentimes more cinematic. There's epic things like choirs and orchestras, usually a lot of strings and things like that. And I will very briefly play this one tune. Gotta finish. Oh my god! Okay, I'm gonna jump ahead. This is in a dungeon. So different from Hammerhead, right? This is spooky as hell.
Give me back my harmonica.
There's no harmonica. Okay, cool. So that gives you an idea. So I always like to leave these panels with exercises. So if you want to take this home with you, if you want to take this knowledge home with you, here's what you can do with our little Moogle friend. Okay. So number one, when you're playing any game, not just Final Fantasy games, but any game, you should ask yourself, how does the music show the action and setting? Just like how Hammerhead kind of showed what location you were in based on what instruments you're playing, based on what it sounded like. It gives you an idea of the location or the action, where the action is. Okay. Number two, what emotions does the music want you to feel? Does it want you to be happy? Does it want you to feel uncomfortable? Does it want you to feel dread? What does the music want you to feel? Number three, do you feel those emotions? Do you feel those emotions when you hear that and see that, hear that music in that setting? And if so, why or why not? I think we have one more. Yes. And because it was all of that in mind, is the soundtrack successful? Is the soundtrack successful? So think about these things whenever you play any game, not just Final Fantasy games, but any game you like to play, even like Madden.
Well, who plays that?
Nobody does. Nobody here. Oh, okay. Well, and that's it for me. Thank you. We have a couple minutes.